big thank you to the CannaTech team for having me today. As just heard, we're going to talk about today just third-party certification for the cannabis industry, what that means, what the benefits are, some of the nomenclature around it. I'll tell you a little bit about my background first and how I got here. The first part of my career was spent in the mental health industry and public health and changing stigma around depression and anxiety. From there, I went to work for Eli Lilly and Company in pharmaceuticals, first in government relations and then in sales. When I left there in 2011, Arizona, which is where I'm from, had just legalized medical cannabis. And some friends asked me to open a license with them because I had some good relationships with the public health authorities and regulatory bodies. I didn't know anything about cannabis. I will raise my hand that I had tried it and inhaled, but other than that, it was kind of a non-starter for me. Eventually they talked me into doing this and I just fell in love with this industry. It was just so invigorating to see patients being helped by this medicine and really provide a good alternative to pharmaceuticals. During that 3 years, so we opened the first license in Phoenix, Arizona, and it's vertical integration in Arizona. So we had a dispensary, a couple 40,000 square foot grows. We opened four more dispensaries over the next couple of years. We had a manufacturing lab, an infused products kitchen. And through that process, I learned not only the benefits of this medicine, but also the challenges that happen when you try to scale something that's been grown on a small scale for a long time in manufacture. So I want to start just clarifying certification and accreditation. So there's a lot of different terms involved in the certification world outside of cannabis, and these two get confused all the time. Oh, that didn't work very well, did it? So third-party certification just means that somebody outside of your organization comes in and they inspect your processes and documentation and policies to assure that the end product that you provide is safe, consistent, and of good quality. I'm sure you've heard of this in other industries, whether it's agriculture or manufacturing, pharmaceutical companies all go through this. Basically, it's a proven concept. It allows outside stakeholders to verify and feel comfortable with the products that you're producing. So when we think about certification in the cannabis industry, there's a lot of different options out there as far as individual specific companies. Versus when you look at certification in other industries, there are decades old organizations that are providing these services. And so one of the real challenges with certification in the cannabis industry is to understand what you're getting for that certification and what that actually means. And that's where accreditation comes in. Accreditation is just a formal recognition that a certification body has practices that are competent, ethical, and that they actually assure quality. I'm gonna just talk a little bit about this because, so I'm sure everyone's familiar with ISO, International Organization for Standardization. That is the global body that creates standards. It also accredits standards development bodies in each country. And so what I've listed here is South Africa, Israel, Australia, and the US bodies for ISO. These companies do not provide third-party certification. They accredit certification bodies. So it's basically whatever country that your company is based in has to go through one of these organizations, and they will look at all your policies and procedures as a certifying body. They look at your audit capabilities, the training, the documentation policies, and determine that you meet this international standard to be able to provide certification. So it's really critical when you're looking at certification bodies in any industry to make sure that the certification body is accredited. Don't think I need to explain that one. These are a few of the things that the accrediting body looks for in a certification body. So obviously the benefit globally is that they are assessing to a standard regardless of where that operation is. So if you think about cannabis and we're trying to slowly grow this as an import export, obviously US being way behind, an accredited certification allows companies and products to cross borders, right? Standards are the language for international trade. And so it doesn't matter if you have a third party certification audit in South Africa or in Arizona, where I'm from, or in Australia. It's all the same and the meaning is the same. So it really gives a signal of quality of your product and your processes around the world, regardless of where you are from. As a certification body, we are overseen by the accreditation board. So any processes that we have, just like, so if we go out and certify a cannabis company, we look at all your processes and procedures. Accreditation bodies are the ones who certify or accredit us. And I'm just trying to make this clear because there's a lot of nomenclature that's really confusing. So my company focus, we started developing standards in 2014. We followed all ISO guidelines for standards, and we are in the process of finalizing our accreditation with ANSI, the ISO body for the USA. Our certification is specific to cannabis. We looked at and considered global cannabis regulations, World Health Organization guidelines for good manufacturing, good ag, good production, good distribution. We took Code of Federal Regulations from the United States, from supplements, pharma, food, OSHA, HACCP, and we created standards to make them meet the needs of the cannabis industry and the nomenclature, which is super important. We end up with four types of certification that we offer: primary production or cultivation, growing, manufacturing, retail, and laboratory. And all four of the certifications go through the same basic system of what we certify to. So we're looking at your management system overall, which really encompasses everything in your business, right? So we're not just looking at a test of an end product. We're looking at how do you train your employees? What are the hygiene practices within your organization? How do you maintain your facility? What does your supplier qualification and your supply chain look like? Anything that can and will affect the end product and the quality and safety of that. Certification processes differ from organization to organization. Ours is very straightforward. A client comes to us and says, hey, we'd like to be certified. We take an application, we sign a contract. Internally, we assign an audit team. And then the first step is a documentation review. So we look at what does your business have as far as documentation and what do you need to have? On-site readiness review, also called a pre-assessment, is like a gap assessment. So we go into your facility and we walk through and we look at where you are today versus where you are, where you need to be to go through certification and achieve certification. From there, clients receive a report of all the things that they need to fix in order to achieve certification. Once that's done, and we verify that internally through a software platform that we provide to our clients. So you upload documents, cross-reference them with the line items in the standard. Once that's all done, we'll do a digital review remotely, and then we'll come out and schedule a certification audit. And at that time, we're just literally confirming that everything that you said you were doing in your documentation is actually happening in your operations. Once that goes well, and there can be, you know, instances where you might have non-conformances and you need some remediation work and things to fix it. Once that's all done, you will receive a notice of certification. For us, the process internally goes to an outside certification board made of independent experts from Food and Drug Administration and employees, and you receive your certification. At that time, you also receive marketing materials, education for your patients, consumers, clients, and you are listed in an international registry of certified companies that will be listed on our website, but it also goes and is listed to a international registry as well. And so it really signifies that this company has achieved quality higher than typical companies in the industry. So why certify? What are the benefits? Obviously, in any industry, the basic benefit of certification is to make sure your business runs well, to make sure that you've accounted for all different considerations. When I ran the cannabis business in Arizona, we had a perfect example, we had many, but of why certification would have helped us, right? So we had white flies and spider mites inside one of our grows, and got rid of the whole lot of plants, cleaned the whole room, put new clones back in, let them grow, and a week later we've got the white flies back. Happened two more times, wasting almost 2 weeks, until we realized, wow, nobody cleaned the air filter. We're just blowing this stuff back on the plants, right? So part of certification is verifying that your processes actually control what they're supposed to. The cleaning procedure is something that would have been verified through certification to prevent that happening. And in case that seems like an insignificant thing to you, it costs us hundreds of thousands of dollars to waste that time and all those materials. But as far as to the business, it goes in specifics, right? Ease of expansion. While global cannabis regulations are all over the board, I think our last presenter just made a great point of that, and it's very sort of willy-nilly on what you can do in Canada versus the US versus here versus Israel. So this really allows you to meet a global standard instead of just regulations. So if you think of opening a new restaurant, a new restaurant to open is great, right? It's so easy. You take your business model and you move it to the next restaurant and you open the restaurant. But you can't do that with cannabis right now because there's different laws and regulations in every country. So one of the things that is the real benefit, especially at this point in the cannabis industry, is being able to expand and not have to change all your processes just to meet regulations, right? You need the standards, and then minor adaptations are done to meet the regulations. Overall, brand protection and risk mitigation is huge. I'm not sure what that looks like in South Africa, but I can tell you in the US and Canada, we've seen some really big organizations that have gone through recalls, have had, you know, terrible things that have happened where it's related to a consumer good and the safety and quality of that, that could have been protected and prevented before through the implementation of standards. I am out of time. I don't think I've ever talked for only 15 minutes in my life, but I'm around for the next couple days if you guys would like any more information, and our website is up there. So thank you very much.